Nityanandeshwara Sadashiva Samarambham Nityanandeshwariyadi Shakti Madhyamam Asmadacharya Parayantam Vande Guru Paramparam. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome everyone sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Diksha. On this auspicious Navratri, fourth day celebration, today Devi Adishakti is gracing all of us on Rajarajeshwari Alankara with Lakshmi and Saraswati, fanning her, serving her in all her glory. Angushabasa, Panjabana, in Sarvalankara and Vishnu is gracing as Sri Krishna as part of the Venkateshwara Srivari Brahmotsava on Seshavahana, Swarna Seshavahana, golden Seshavahana is gracing us in Krishna Alankara as Krishna. Let's receive their blessings and then enter into Satsang.
Om Dorvasi Dorva Dorvantam Dorvatam Yasman Dorvatitam Dorvayam Vayam Dorvamastvam Devanamasi Sasitamam Papritamam Jushtatamam Vanhitamam Devahutamam Amritavasir Avirtanam Rigumasvam Ahva Mitrasya Tvachakshusha Prekshema Virma Samviktam Atvahikum Sishum Nityanandeshwariyadi Shaktaye Namo Namaha Rupam Agrapayami Shri Venkateshwara Swamine Namo Namaha Rupam Agrapayami Ata Deepaha Om Deepya Swajata Vedo Pagne Niraditam Mama Pashogushcha Mahyama Vahajeevanam Chatishodisha Mano Higum Sijata Vedoga Mashvam Purusham Jagade Abe Pradagnaga Histriyama Paripataya Shri Nityanandeshwariyadi Shaktaye Namo Namaha Deepam Darshayami Shri Venkateshwara Swamine Namo Namaha Deepam Darshayami Naivedyam Om Madhuvatardaya De Madhukcharanti Sindhavaha Madhvirna Santoshadihi Madhunakta Madoshasi Madhuvat Parthi Vagum Rajaha Madhudyorastuna Pita Madhumano Vanaspatir Madhuvagum Mastu Suryaha Madhvirgavo Bhavantunaha Madhu 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 Shri Nityanandeshwariyadi Shaktaye Namo Namaha Naivedhyam Nivedayami Shri Venkateshwara Swamine Namo Namaha Naivedhyam Nivedayami Maharatrikam Om Namo Devyai Mahadevyai Shivayai Satadam Namaha Namah Prakrityai Bhadrayai Niyatah Pranadasmadam Rodrayai Namo Nityayai Gauryai Dhatrayai Namo Namaha Jyotsnayai Chendurupinyai Shikayai Satadam Namaha.
With Navaratri starts festive season in Hindu tradition. Funnily, it doesn't end. It comes back to Navaratri. That's the beauty of Sanatana Hindu Dharma. It's full of colorful festivals, celebrations. Actually, if you are just practicing Hindu, eating all the Nivedyams specially prepared for those celebrations, you will be in complete health. Understand? Fortunately, India was never visualized by those kind of visionaries. It's by rishis. Everything indigenous. Understand? Every 100 mile. Why mile? Kilometer. Every 100 kilometer will have its own cooking style. Its own dressing style. Its own fabric. Forget about dressing style. Its own fabric. Such colorful, rich, indigenous, self-sustaining system. Understand? Each mandala, each taluk was self-sustaining. Those days there was no transportation. But everyone had everything. How? I tell you, one of the biggest sickness humanity has been forced to suffer is chronic capitalism. This chronic capitalist thinking is what makes these brands and anything other than the brands are destroyed in the bud itself. Every 50 kilometer has its own food style. Every 100 kilometer has its own clothes style. Every 200 kilometer have its own fabric. We were so indigenous, so colorful, rich, finally independent. I tell you, each house was visualized as an independent unit. They will just have few fruits, vegetables, herbs, trees, which is not only self-sustaining for their food habits, even for their medical needs. It used to be self-sustaining, even for their medical needs, including the emergency needs like poisoning, food poisoning, or some poisonous animals, bites, all that. We were such powerful indigenous tradition. Actually, just few days before, two of my Adinavasis, I sent with my mother to my hometown, Thiruvannamalai, native place, telling them, just go and study how my uncles do business. My pre-monastic family, mother's side and father's side, both of them are in rice business. It's rice merchandise. How they procure from the local farmers and how dharmic they are in their deals. I tell you, I have seen my grandfather doing business. Around 500 farmers were his customers, means who supply rice for him and all other agricultural products and take money from him after it is sold. He was running a wholesale godown. And I tell you, never I have seen a single farmer having any distrust, incompletion, complaint about any money transaction, and no money transaction is ever noted down or recorded. It's all just in memory. No promissory notes, no legal documents, not even noting down in the paper and pen and in the notebook. There used to be Arunachaleshwara and Unnamalai's photo behind him. He will take the money and show it to them and put it in his gala and tell them, the word, the integrity to the word, that's it. I was his favorite. And I'll get a lot of time to sit around him and absorb the way he does the business. And all the agricultural products are tax exempted in this country, so you don't need to file any tax return or any tax related issues. Tax exempt is separate, no tax is different, but the way they conduct the business, the way the integrity and the trust and the way they keep the things simple, just by integrity, things are simplified. And my grandfather can see the size of the gunny bag and tell the weight. It is just getting involved with things. I sent to Adinavasis, just go and study how they run business. Now much has changed. Even then that flavor is there. How the indigenous cultures function. How the indigenous people function. Whether the way they grow or the way they move, the way they transport itself is such a celebration. Literally the whole family will get into that bullock cart. That is like a vacation, family vacation. From their place where they grow unto that main selling market, it will be something like a 40 kilometers, 30 kilometers. It will take 2 days in that bullock cart. How 3-4 bullock carts together? All the family will get into the bullock carts and with all their cooking vessel, and the way how they stop and cook and eat and sleep in the in one bullock cart, and how they take care of the bullocks, animals, as part of their life. While they pack food, the first thing they make sure they pack enough food for the bullocks, animals. And how the animals are part of the family. The whole culture, the indigenous lifestyle, and how they go to, I have seen those routes in which they come. All the temples on the way will never be poor, because These guys have the habit, all the temples on the way, they will give one share to those temples. That way, the village is kept out of poverty. What will the temples do? The temples collect all that. It is like a no tax, but as offering. The temples, they collect these offerings and they feed the local poor villagers, poor people, and maintain that road. The temples are responsible for maintaining the roads. So, instead of paying the toll, which is sucked by the multinational, chronic capitalistic corporate structure, the food is shared, in turn the road is maintained. I was shocked the way the whole, please understand, religion is so beautifully embedded, no farmer will go without donating to a local temple, and no local temple will miss their responsibility of maintaining that stretch of their road. It is like a perfectly unmonitored but superbly managed system. Understand? Being monitored is different, being managed is different. Unmonitored, superbly managed. Independent structure. Unmonitored but managed is what I call Dharma. Understand? Unmonitored but managed is Dharma. Nobody is monitoring sun and the moon. They are all managed by their integrity. By the strength of their own integrity, they are all managed. Unmonitored but managed. This is my vision for my Sangha. Unmonitored, independently managed by their own integrity. By their own integrity. That is Dharma. Understand? The celebrative lifestyle of Hinduism is centered on this Dharmartha Kama Moksha. The principle of Moksha is celebrated by the lifestyle of Dharma, which generates and shares the Artha, wealth, which is in turn celebrated and enjoyed by the Kama. Understand? Unmonitored but maintained by its own integrity, that Dharma does not create stress on citizens. It is not law which needs enforcement department. It's a Dharma which just needs enlightenment department. O Bharat! Unfortunately, you followed the British and still following the British and destroyed your enlightenment department. That is why you need enforcement department. Get back to your enlightenment department. Indigenous mechanism of managing. Understand? the indigenous mechanism of managing is temple-based lifestyle. Temple-based lifestyle, where literally no enforcement is required. No enforcement is required. Dharma, unmonitored but managed. Artha, generated to be shared. Generated to be shared is Artha. Understand? Whatever we considered as wealth can never be held. Holdings is not possible in Indian wealth. Whatever can be held was never considered as wealth. So that the chronic capitalism is kept out of our lifestyle. All things needed for living was kept out of the holding or hoarding. The title wealth was given only to perishable, understand, dhanadhanya. Perishable were given the title of dhana, wealth. So you can't hold, you can't hoard. Generate only to share. Create only to share. Almost 90% of the transactions was held within the perishable goods. So the regular life became too easy. A regular life person was not affected by the greed of the chronic capitalistic mental setup. Understand, chronic capitalism is not restricted to a person, it is a thought current. Even if you kill one person, somebody else will occupy that seat. Wall Street is going to be alive as long as the thought current exists. Las Vegas is going to be alive as long as that gambling thought current exists. Even if one person dies, somebody else is going to replace. Playing with the probability gives certain kick to human beings. That is what is expressed in Las Vegas, that kick of playing with the probability. We transformed that into a prayer of playing with the probability with the divine. The best playing with probability is Tirupati, the worst Las Vegas. Playing with probability. Playing with the probability of the prayer, playing with the probability of the luck. The Las Vegas kick breaks your nervous system. The Tirupati kick heals your nervous system. Actually, if you see the same thought current in its most raw, crude form is Las Vegas, most refined, scientifically constructed form is Tirupati. All the money gathers in the Las Vegas goes for who knows what, but all the money gathers in Tirupati goes for public service. social service, charity, thought current transformed, generated to share. Karma, sharing generates the life, is karma. Understand? Unmonitored but managed is dharma. Generated to share is artha. By sharing, generating is kama. By the time you go through all these three, you will understand the underlying oneness of life. That evolution is moksha. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Understand? You would have been listening to many of the disciples giving sakshi pramana, how they manifest wealth to be more straight currency, money. Understand? Anything you manifest to share, to celebrate, that is what I call as wealth. Manifesting to celebrate is the wealth. Manifesting to share is the wealth. Hindus need to understand our ancestors had the best, most stable, highly responsible social thought current, understand, and social construct. You have been told by all the anti-Hindu and anti-Indian, anti-nationalist forces, Hinduism is responsible for our poverty. No! They swindle you and tell you, you are responsible for your poverty. No. Not practicing Hindu thought currents is responsible for our poverty. Not practicing our Dharmartha Kama Moksha system was responsible for our poverty. Understand? Hey, till these fellows invaded us, we were the richest country in the world. Otherwise, why will they invade us? If we are so poor, so ignorant, why did he invade us? Why will that stupid Gajini Mukhamadu will come to Somanath for 17 times if we were not rich? Every time he came, he got enough gold required to have at least 10 more army, which he lost in one war. That is the reason he was coming again and again. The only mistake we have done, we were not brutal. We treated human beings, even in the war, we had a dharma. That was the only mistake. We attack with equal weapons. If I am on the elephant, if you are not on the elephant, I won't touch you. If I am on the horse, if you are not on the horse, I will not attack you. If I am with the weapon and if you are not with the weapon, I will not attack you. We were dharmic even in the war. That is the only mistake we have done. Nothing else. We were not brutal in our war strategies. We never know guerrilla war. Even our gorillas, monkeys, Hanuman Sena, Rama Sena did only dharmic war. Even our gorillas did dharmic war. Never missed dharma. So we do not know guerrilla war. We do not know. Adharmic structure, that was the only mistake. Otherwise, I tell you, our ancestors were such amazing visionaries. I tell you, still we are the only living civilization for more than 8,000 years. If Manu comes back for a visit, how we believe Mahabali comes back for every Onam to see Kerala, I tell you, he will not find any difference other than few LED TV screens and the kids playing with the laptops. He will not find any difference. If Manu comes back and walks through our villages, he will not have cultural shock. Few thousand years we survived. That shows the social construct structure. I tell you, it is just because of our celebrating lifestyle. We never had one day religious gathering per week. No. We never had that. But always the thought current was circulated in all our locality just by celebrations, rituals and traditions. The modern day Hindu organizations should understand the Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha of the Hindu tradition. Only then you will be promoting and protecting Hinduism. Otherwise, you will only be a reaction for the anti-Hindu forces. As a reaction, you don't have existence. Understand reaction as life, but not existence. They live as long as the action exists, but they don't have an independent existence. But if you understand the principles of Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha, you have existence to promote Sanatana Hindu Dharma. We should react when there is act, But reaction alone cannot be the life and purpose of Hindu organizations. It should be understanding, living, promoting the thought currents of Dharmartha Kama Moksha. Indigenous thought currents should be strengthened by the social media and law. Law, media, and social moral structures all should support the indigenous administrative systems, self-managing systems. The thought currents of Dharmartha Kama Moksha. I tell you, everything, our structure, the worship of the Kuladevata, worship of the Kuladevata is the place where we chose brides and bridegrooms. That is the matrimonial website for us. Everything. The indigenous traditions and its strength. The Sanatana Hindu Dharma and its powerful social construct is strongly intertwined with these celebrations and festivals. All these celebrations and festivals are also very strongly intertwined with the science of manifestation. During each of this season, the whole cosmology, the logic of the cosmos, supports you manifesting shaktis. Manifesting powers. The logic of the cosmos. Even if you go to an ordinary farmer, villager, he will talk about life, death, beyond life, Maya, Jagat, Jiva, Ishwara, 10 times more than any Harvard University philosophy professors or doctorates. Go to Indian village, then you will understand. A normal, ordinary Indian village farmer will speak more philosophy than Harvard University philosophy professors. Because the Puranas, our lifestyle. Every village will have a Draupadi temple where they will read the Mahabharata every summer. The whole village will know the whole story. I heard Mahabharata and Ramayana when I was 3. These great truths, imbibed, inculcated, incorporated, with this celebration lifestyle. And I wanted this lifestyle to be absorbed, kept alive, enjoyed, shared, and spread. The first act of engaging with public by our Sangha should be celebration, like a Kumbh Mela, festivals and celebrations like Navaratri, Shivaratri, Kirtans, processions. Nididhyasana means constructing a thought current and manifesting it as reality, as real as the oneness. Vedic tradition does not have meditation. Shunya dhyana, oh God. Purana, puranatva is not non-existence, it is all existence. And the shunya and purna are not one and the same in experience. The puranatva described by Upanishads, shunyatva described by Buddha, completely differ. And shunyatva described by Buddha is not ultimate goal. People enjoy life negative things. As I was telling yesterday, a frustrated human being wants cessation. Now I am telling, nirodha does not mean cessation. Yogaha chitta vritti nirodha means yoga is transforming the chitta vrittis into oneness, not cessation. Understand, cessation means destroying, non-existing, getting rid. Nirodha means getting back. Getting back is not getting rid. Nirodha is not cessation. Maximalarian blunder of translating nirodha into cessation, getting rid is different, getting back is different. Yogaha chitta vritti nirodha, not nirodha. Nirodha, not nirodha. Yogaha chitta vritti nirodha, getting back, not getting rid. In yesterday spiritual alchemy sessions, I was talking how people enjoy life negative things. That is why the shunyatva is becoming very popular. Shunyatva is devil worship. Purnatva is worship of Sadashiva. How can all existence and no existence be one and the same? Then loving all and loving nobody is one and the same? Then the extreme indrawn depression and the ultimate samadhi is one and the same. So Sushupti and Turiyadita is one and the same. let me be very clear. Pratyahara is not withdrawing, giving different ahara. Tarana is not withdrawing, flowing in a focused direction. Dhyana is not emptying yourself, but by constructing the right thought currents which leads you to the space of oneness. I give this as rule, command to the Nithyananda Sangha. Our first interaction with the public, society, humanity should be festivals, celebrations, and caring and sharing of this great Sanatana Hindu Dharma, the spiritual tradition. Understand, it should be Navaratri, Shivaratri, Ganesh Chaturthi, Guru Purnima, what not? It should be processions, kirtans, singing, dancing, not your meditation. How you do meditation, I know. First your two eyes, look into your third eye. Then all three eyes look into your tummy. Because you are doing body scanning. You look in. I know the meditation. I have seen all cultural people doing meditation. Easterners bend east, Westerners bend west. Celebrations, festivals are such wonderful way of keeping the traditions alive and getting the benefits of the great Sanatana Hindu Dharma and its traditions. Let this be on record, let the history tell. Nithyananda might have started teaching meditation, but he became matured and moved out of meditation. He moved out of the Maximilarian Buddhistic interpretations and translations of the Hindu tradition and got back to his original grounding. The Gupta Kailasa Sampradaya, from which he comes to reveal that to the world for which he landed on the planet Earth. Understand, I am from the Gupta Kailasa Sampradaya. The Kailasa kept as a secret. Raja Vidya Raja Guhya. And I have come to reveal that to the world and share it with the world. It is enough. It has been kept as Gupta. Now it need to be shared with the world. The time has come. Celebrate. That is the way you will enjoy the Sanatana Hindu Dharma and share it with the world, keeping it alive. I bless you all. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhatvaita Saivam, Sadashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nithyananda. Thank you. Be blissful.